industry was not used to this kind of thinking. The zero defects was more confined to the software development and maintenance. In the IT infrastructure management space, no one was thinking about this zero incident. So in that way, this is a clear disruptor. And having decided that we should drive the organization towards zero incident, we felt the need of an artificial intelligence based platform. It was 3 years ago. At that point of time, there was not much products or tools about artificial intelligence. And we were one of the first to come out with an artificial intelligence platform. This engine sees the environment like a human, thinks like a human, feels like a human, and actually takes a decision like a human, what is happening in the environment. It is very difficult for a human to sit in the entire network and see each device, each performance metric, and then decide whether this is going to affect or not. So this has the capability of finding out even if one of the performance in one server is behaving abnormally, what is the effect of that in the business in terms of whether that application would be performing fine or not, it was able to give that. This we have been running in 7 to 10 organizations, and we are able to reduce the noise in the organizations by 50% and reduce their impact, that is, increase their uptime by 50% more, and increase the user experience by 30% to 40%. That's the power of this artificial intelligence platform. Now, coming back to this artificial intelligence and prediction, somewhere down the line we felt that the power of the engine is centrally depending upon the kind of data that we feed into this engine. And then we felt the need for generating our own tool to generate the data from the environment. So we have come out of the own tool which generates the data that captures the health of the environment, each application, each server, each component in the server. And that is fed into this Gavel, the AI platform. And which was helpful for Gavel to predict accurately and help the IT managers and CEOs to act in time before that incident actually happens.
And as an extension, just to give a logical conclusion, we have actually filed for about 4 patents, and we are in the process of getting 3 more patents filed up. And the primary reason is these are something distinct algorithms which we have built, and want to ensure that those are protected properly. So IP-led, technology-led is the way to go for us in terms of delighting our customers.
I'm Narasimha Sharan, CFO for Yavs. So it's exciting times ahead for Yavs, where we are really looking for an exponential growth. One is the organic one, and the organic one, whatever Balaji, Sumit, and Chandra mentioned about those IP-led solutions. And the inorganic also we are looking at to reach our aspirational goal of reaching 200 million. So it's exciting time ahead for us. Thank you.